quite enough of that. We're just enjoying So Many Lies there with what I dub the Cockney Christmas theme, which is quite fun. We've got the Improv Society in the studio. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
How's it all going?
Yeah, not bad, Dario. How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine,
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah. I know.
Look, I'm just going to press the button.
Yeah, can I press the button?
Yeah! And now, live from Nottingham's Portland building, ladies and gentlemen, it's the impromptu comedy stylings of The Improv Show!
All right, my lover. Hello, welcome to The Improv Show. I'm Gareth. With me today, I have Katja.
Hey!
I have Josie.
Hello.
And I also have Harry Turnbull.
Heyo.
Today, I looked up what International Day it was on the internet, and it turns out it is International Old Farmers Day. So today I will be mostly speaking like this, in a terrible Somerset accent, even though I'm from Somerset. Who'd have funk it?
Boom.
What? Yeah? Okay. Should we start with a proper game? We're going to play a game called Luxury. We played it last week. It's really fun. Basically, Dario tells us his pet hate, which I think he's got one already in his head.
My pet hate is when cats look at you suggestively and you get confused.
And I'd say, luxury! When cats stare at me, I just think to myself that they're eating my soul.
Luxury! When the cats stare at me, I know they're plotting to take over the earth and enslave all humans.
Luxury. When cats look at me, I think they're going to eat the earth.
Oh, luxury. When I was a young boy, the cats, they didn't even have eyes to stare with. They just sit there facing those little empty pockets at you.
Luxury. What I would do to have a cat stare at me. In fact, I've never seen a cat. I live in the middle of a road. All I get for cat's eyes are literally cat's eyes in the middle of the road.
Luxury. Where I live, there are no roads for cat's eyes to roll around on. All I get is stares from owls, which have even bigger eyes that are even creepier.
Oh, luxury. Owls. When I was a young lad, we had falcons attacking us from each and every direction, tearing at our eyes and the cat's eyes. That's why the cats had no eyes, because they've been torn out by falcons.
Luxury. Last time a cat looked at me, I went through with it.
Luxury. When I was young, I decided that I'd do something for the greater good of mankind. Now every day I'm eaten apart by different birds of prey. There's a reason they call me Prometheus.
Luxury. When I was nailed to a rock as punishment for my crimes of stealing fire from the gods, I wasn't even alive. I was dead.
Luxury. I have to die every day and then wake up again and then die again and wake up again the next day and die again whilst I'm picked apart by an eagle.
Luxury. When I'm dead, I have to roll a stone up a hill every day and then get eaten alive by wild, ravenous harpies.
Luxury. When I'm dead, I have to wait 3 days before I can come back to life. Do you know how tedious it is to wait through a whole weekend doing nothing?
Alright, calm down, Jesus.
It's
Jesus Christ is in the building. Okay, I'm sorry, that was awful. I'm going to press this button just on myself. We'll play a proper game now. I'm going to keep saying that all the way through until the end. And now, Dario will do some proper stuff. We're going to play Change. Change is really fun. Start with a scene, then I'll say change to change what the person has just said, and they've got to carry on changing what they just said. So if I asked Dario for a suggestion of a word,
horse,
change,
herpes,
change,
etymology.
So the scene for Harry and Katja is a horse with herpes.
Oh, well, this horse here, you are right to call me the vet, because it's very ill. It's got herpes.
I knew it was something bad. Tell me, doctor, what can I do?
Well, I'm afraid we can't just shoot it.
Change.
We can just shoot it, but you might want to consider an alternative.
Change.
You might want to consider an enema. We can give this horse an enema, which will help flush out the herpes.
Change.
Which will help flush out all the poo.
That would be quite convenient, actually. I mean, have you smelled what it is like in here?
Change.
Have you seen what it looks like in here?
Change.
Have you ever seen so much horse poo in one pile? I'm actually really proud of it.
Aye, that's more horse poo than you can shake a stick at. Well, here we go with the enema. Lucky I bring my enormous horse enema kit to every single call I
Change.
Get. Luckily, I bring a hose pipe that I can fix to the tap to every single call I get called to.
Well, they don't call you the best vet in the country for nothing, I
Change.
Guess. Well, they don't call you the horse herpes expert for nothing, I guess.
Change.
Well, they don't call you very often, do they?
No, they don't. It's usually because I turn up with an enormous horse pipe.
Yeah, I can see why that would scare people. So, should I hold the horse?
Aye, you hold the horse there, and I'll go run the back, and I'll just insert this hose pipe into the rear end of the horse there. Calm down.
Yeah! Black Beauty.
Don't make me get the shotgun.
Change.
Don't make me get the lethal injection.
Change.
Don't make me get the poisoned sugar cubes.
Don't tell her that. She loves sugar cubes. She's actually going to want them now.
Alright, well, let's get on with this. Now, I'll get the other end of the hose pipe and plug it into this here tap and turn it on.
Like this.
Change voice, sound effect.
Like this.
Change sound effect.
Like this.
Change sound effect.
Like this.
Change sound effect.
You mean like this?
Ah, well, look at all that poo that's just come out the back there.
Did it help with the herpes, though?
Oh, aye, yes, this is herpes-infested poo.
Well done, guys. And so the vet saved the horse with herpes-infested poo. Well done, Dario. That was Dario doing a pretty impressive horse impression, then.
Thank you. I've been practicing for years. It's what I did through my childhood. So
you've been practicing for years, and it was only that good. I mean, it was okay, but it wasn't.
I do a really good cow.
Go on then. I think we need the vet. I think this
quite
think,
good actually.
I think this cow's got herpes.
I've got a
What's
pretty
that?
Big reptile.
That's yeah. pig. That was pretty good.
Happy Old Farmer's Day, everybody.
Josie, do you want to have a go?
Let's go ahead.
Yeah. Who wants to go with Josie, Harry or Katja?
Everyone.
Might as Both well. Of you.
Let's
oh, three person.
Ooh. Three person change. Okay, so we're going to do a scene that is about Old Farmer. Okay, we have the suggestion is going to be tractors.
I'm glad you've come to help me fix this tractor that is yellow.
Ah, well, that's no problem. You know, I'm a mechanic in my spare
Boss.
Time from being a vet.
Boss, where do you want the toolkit?
Ah, just pop it down there on the floor next to the tractor.
You're also a vet. Heavy. That's good. This tractor has a horse
Change.
Drawn.
It's a horse-drawn tractor, I see. Well, is it a flat tire or something?
Change.
Is it a broken radiator tube?
Change.
Is it a split valve?
Change.
Is it a fractured wheel arch?
That sounds about correct, but I think it's also the engine.
The engine.
Backup engine.
The backup engine. Well,
when
how many backups
dies.
Do you have? Is it on the third backup yet?
Well, that's only the second backup.
Change.
Oh, well.
It's actually the fourth backup
Change.
That's broken. It's actually the tenth backup that's broken.
Oh, well. Better change all of those other nine engines as well, just to be sure. Right, better get to it then. Assistant, could you fetch those 9 engines?
Do you mean I have to carry them here?
Yes. Right, while she's doing
that... I'm
really
sorry, but change sound effect. Change sound effect.
One.
Right, while she's doing that, I'll take your payment details.
Which would you like them on? Visa, 4. MasterCard, PayPal, check?
Can you pay me in beads?
6,
change.
7.
Can you pay me in meals?
Change.
Can you pay me in illicit favours?
I'm a farmer. I own farm animals. What kind of illicitness do you want?
I like where this is going. Can I have...
These are examples of farm animals.
A couple of pigs and chicken.
One chicken.
Just the one.
Most people want two, but go ahead.
I'm a man with very particular needs.
Change.
I'm a man with very particular requirements.
Change.
I'm a man with very particular interests.
We noticed.
Yeah, I think we all noticed. Me and Dario got distracted there, just doing animal impressions. But I forgot to say change.
It stopped becoming about the comedy.
Yeah, just became about me and Dario and our duo that is good.
Don't talk to me.
Your menagerie of farmyard animal noises.
See, you do this all the time, Dario. I try to start a conversation with you and you just cut me down.
Sorry,
you're always speaking over me when I'm trying to... What?
I do try sometimes, but it's just I look at your face and...
We're playing another game. Okay. Out the mic, please. I'm going to play Magazine. Did you bring in the Metro with you?
We have the Metro.
We have the Metro. This is going to be a much better version of anything that ever reads a newspaper because Harry is going to tell a lovely story about... some old farmers, probably.
I am.
And I'm going to say Magazine, and Josie's going to read out what she's just read in the Metro, and then Harry's going to incorporate that into his story. So, the name of the story will be Farmer John and his...
pet cactus.
This is a story of Farmer John and his pet cactus.
Once upon a time, there was a farmer whose name was John. And he had a pet cactus called Philip. One day, Philip and John were on a lovely walk through the farmyard.
Magazine.
House prices set to fall.
John said to Philip, "Oh, it's terrible news. The house price has been set to 4. We can't sell it right now because then we'll only get £4 for it. And the farmhouse is worth much more than £4. We'll have to wait till the house price is set to, I don't know, 40,000 at least." Philip didn't make a reply.
Magazine.
Fake fur greatcoat.
He was too disgusted by the fake fur greatcoat that John had been wearing. You see, Philip was a member of PETA, the animal rights group, and he had been campaigning in London against the use of fur in fashion shows, and he just got back from that.
Magazine.
The caravan company.
While he was staying in London, Philip had stayed in a caravan which he had bought from a company. There's not much else to say about that because there's not many places you can pitch up a caravan in London because it's full of taxis and post boxes. But nevertheless, John continued to saunter through the farmyard next to his farmhouse in his lovely fur coat.
Magazine.
500 pet parrots.
When he was suddenly attacked by his other 500 pets, the 500 pet parrots. Philip stood there, gawping in his cactus-like fashion, unable to act, as to take action against the parrots would contradict his PETA beliefs that no animal should be harmed, even if they are ravaging the life from your owner, Farmer John.
Magazine.
Taking better selfies.
The parrots, whilst attacking John viciously, took selfies and posted this brutal, brutal act upon Twitter, Facebook, and other social networking sites for the reason to incite rage and raise awareness for the tyranny of Farmer John and his cactus Pete.
The end. Well, that was sad. At least the parrot's got a good selfie out of it, eh? Very well done, Harry. So now we're going to go to a song break, which is going to be Man or Muppet. That was Man or Muppet, which is one of my favourite songs. And I was singing it all the way through the ads. Move On and Keep is the next game we're going to be playing. It's a very simple game. They start a scene, and then I say, move on and keep something, and they have to change and keep with that theme that is going to be running through all the scenes. And you just keep doing lots and lots of little scenes. It'll be hilarious. Hopefully. Harry's already not too certain. So we'll start with Josie and Katja, and you will be doing a scene about... Go on, Dario. Give us an amazing suggestion. Drum roll.
Pilots discovering the ground.
Pilots discovering the ground.
Oh, Bill, I don't know, but I am so bored of watching clouds every day.
Same, Caitlin. How long has it been since we've not seen a cloud?
I don't know, but do you ever wonder what's beneath those clouds?
I've never seen anything below there.
All right, let's go down. I want to find out today.
Bing, this is your captain speaking. We are now going down at 300 miles per hour. Bing.
Oh, look at this. It's so brown and jagged. And it
Move on and
so...
keep brown.
Well, Mrs. Brown, what would you like for dinner?
Do you have any antelope?
Yes, we do.
Could I have sautéed antelope with rosemary potatoes?
I'm afraid we've only got it braised.
Oh,
braised so... antelope, yes.
How about crocodile?
Crocodile? We have it poached.
Move on and keep poached.
I've poached a deer from your lands, King. What are you going to do about it? Ha ha ha.
You should know better than to challenge your king. Or queen, for that matter. I just have a bad cold. Off with his head!
No, I must make my daring escape, for I, Richard of Nortinghome, the folk hero who will become Robin
Move
of
on and
Nike.
Keep non-existent towns.
I'm pretty sure there was a town here 5 minutes ago.
I don't think so. No, certainly not. I've been living here all my life. I remember when this was all fields, and it's still fields. I'm telling you, it's all fields.
Well, I was called out here on a police mission to investigate the fact that there used to be a town here 5 minutes ago.
No, I don't know anything about that. No, do you... Sorry.
Do you have some ID on you?
Sir?
Move on and keep ID.
I lost my ID again.
Well...
And my wallet.
You're not getting in here then, toots.
But please, sir, all my friends are inside. They can vouch for me.
They're vouching for you, are they?
Very trustworthy people. Look at them.
Well.
Don't get fooled by the hoods they're wearing.
I'm surprised I let them in here with hoods. They must be excellent people.
They all have ID, and so do I. In fact, they have my ID as well.
Ah, well. Youth in hood! Youth in hood, come over here. Are you her friend?
Hello. Yes. I think I know who she is.
So, do you have her ID?
She doesn't have ID yet.
Well, you can't come into the club.
Move on and keep no entry.
I'm sorry, sir, you can't come through here. There's a no entry sign.
Yeah, but they told me this is a shortcut and I'm really, really, really late.
This shortcut is also a river today because it rained a lot.
I'm a good swimmer.
Can you see how fast this water is moving?
I can swim faster. I can swim faster, I'm sure.
Before we enacted the sign, 15 people died.
I bet I'm faster than any one of those 15 people. Let me take off my clothes and my shoes.
Move on and keep faster than a speeding man.
I'm faster than a speeding man! If that man has a top speed of 5 miles an hour, roughly a light jog.
Well, I'm as fast as a speeding donkey. As long as that donkey can only run at 5 miles per hour.
Well, I'm as strong as several thousand ants.
Well, I'm as strong as myself. Move on and keep competition.
Come now, come all. You can win a stuffed minion if you are quick enough to catch a man that can run at 5 miles per hour.
Oh, I think I can catch that man.
No, I think I can.
Well, then, £5, please, and you might actually win this cute little minion.
Oh, you won't catch me. Come on, then. Come on.
Oh,
come on.
Oh, I'm going to give you all
the money. No. Get away from me. Stop touching my feet. It's against the rules. Tell him. It's against the rules.
I'm sorry. I might have to disqualify you. You touched his feet. That's not allowed.
Yeah, that's right. I win
again.
Sorry,
no minion for you. I'm keeping the money.
I want the minion.
And Dario wins again. And Katja gets to keep the money. But we're a non-profit organisation, so... I'm sorry, Dario's very upset about the fact it's non-profit.
Wow.
You can keep the metro.
You can keep...
We'll leave the metro for you.
You do have to make ends meet, you know?
Yeah. Okay, now we're going to play a game called Complaints Office. Complaints Office is a lot of fun. We've got a company which is going to be called Old Farmers Incorporated.
Obviously.
Fitting with the theme. And Katja is working on the complaints desk of this incorporation that is selling really dodgy objects to people, mis-selling them, and people are coming in to complain about the fact that these objects are so awful. But Katja has found a way
fine.
To justify all of them.
Obviously.
So, we're going to start with Harry. He's come in to complain about the fact that his tractor's got 10 engines in and then none of them are working.
It's a total disgrace.
Good morning here at Old Farmers Inc. How can I help you today?
I'd like to make a complaint, please.
Oh, if that's necessary, please fill out this form and then come back to me.
I'd just like to talk to you about it. I've got this tractor that I bought from you with 10 backup engines, but all but one of them are broken.
Well, you see, there wouldn't be a point to have 10 backup engines if you only needed one or two of them. That's why they break really easily, so you can use all 10 of them and get your whole money's worth.
Ah, well, it's not really working for me. You see, what if this last engine breaks?
Well, then you can use the first one because it has a chain operation system, whereas when the last engine breaks, the first one becomes... Basically, the chain reverses and you have a reverse backup line. So, actually, none of your engines will ever be really broken.
Wow, that's amazing.
It says that all in the manual. I bet you didn't read that, did you?
No, I didn't read the manual.
See, that's what you tell all our customers. They're supposed to read the manual. That's why we type it for you.
Ah, amazing. Thank you very much.
I hope you enjoy your backup engines.
But there's one more thing.
Yes.
It won't turn on.
Have you tried using the key?
It didn't come with a key. It came with a sausage.
Well, that's because farmers often get very hungry before they try to operate their tractors.
Oh, we do.
See, you're not supposed to handle any heavy machinery when you're tired or feeling dizzy. That's why we have a sausage instead of a key, to get you going before the tractor.
I see. All right. Well, I'll have to go and eat that sausage first, then.
Go ahead. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Well done, Katja. And now we have Josie coming in. And what is she complaining about, Dario?
She's got a spade that itches. Just can't stop scratching that spade.
Hello, I'd like to make a complaint.
Oh, so many complaints today. I don't know what's wrong with you people. Go ahead then, tell me.
I bought a spade from you, and it's really itchy. I can't help scratching the spade. It makes my hands itchy.
So are you scratching the spade or your hands?
Both, at the same time.
Well, see, that's because if the spade was itchy only, you couldn't work. That's why you can just try and do digging by itching. That's our new concept for spades.
That sounds like a brilliant concept, except the hole I'm trying to dig is 6 foot.
Well, then, you should probably purchase a bigger itching spade that will help you dig deeper. Dig deeper. I'm sorry. I probably ate something. Some wrong sausages this morning. Gibberish sausages.
What size is your biggest spade? Because I did buy the 20-foot wide one to start with.
Oh, yeah, maybe you want the 20-foot 1-inch one. That might probably help you a lot. Like, it's only 1 inch, but the difference is enormous. Because the itching, you know, makes it vibrate, and that's why it gets deeper into the ground and loosens the ground so you can dig easier and quicker.
I can see how that 1 inch would really help.
See?
I'll buy it now if that's okay.
Perfect, that would be £20, please.
Cool, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Wow, the complaints office actually sold some stuff. That's pretty impressive. I really want to actually have a go at this. So, Dario, what am I coming in to complain about?
Your haircut.
Whoa! Shots fired!
It's not their fault, but...
I'm sorry, we don't sell haircuts.
Excuse me, my hair looks terrible today. I was hoping you could help sort that out for me.
It does indeed. Oh. Well, did you purchase the scissors from us, though?
I think so. It was a present from my wife. She said, I'll give you a haircut. The old Farmer Incorporated style, and... So I'll
Well,
come.
See, you know, let me take a wild guess here. You're a farmer, right? So you're probably complaining at your wife a lot. Like, the food is not salty enough.
I don't like the idea of you stereotyping all farmers like that, really.
Now, tell me, is it true, though?
Yeah.
That's why we invented this new terrible haircut scissors. So right. that your wife actually has a reason to complain about you. She's going to be like, I don't like your hair anymore. You look terrible in this. And so the nagging becomes mutual.
So you think the fact that I nag too much is a bad thing? You think there should be more equality in the household?
I think so, yeah.
And you think I really agree with that?
Yeah, but your new haircut, which is obviously terrible, will definitely help you fix your marriage.
Really?
I'm certain of it. Oh. Tell me, has your wife been happier since she gave you that haircut?
Well, she doesn't stop smiling when she looks at me, I suppose.
See? When did you last see her smile? Before your haircut?
Suppose that was... the day before I actually said hello to her. Yeah.
See, you're well welcome. Now you have a smiling wife and an ugly haircut.
Oh, okay then.
Please
Thank you very
visit
much.
Us again soon.
Note to self. Have a terrible haircut in the future. Well done, Katja. That was
Any
very
more complaints?
Amusing. Do you want to have a go?
Yes.
Dario wants to have a go. Okay.
Go on, why not?
So, Dario, you've come in to complain about your wonky teeth.
Thank you.
Shots fired.
Hello, I've got a complaint.
Yeah, well, I'm on fire today, so go ahead.
Right. So I'm sorry to hear that. I have wonky teeth. What are you going to do about it?
Well, we have this new product that sells braces that look like pitchforks.
I don't want that. What else have you got? Any other nice ideas?
We have a rock that you can bite on.
Oh, yeah?
So long until you get the shape they want. Do you want them?
How does that work? Can I have a look at it?
Well, you have this big chunky rock, as you can see over here.
Oh, I can see. It's very round and jagged. Well. Looks painful.
No, it's not that painful, actually.
Okay. Is it right if I have a free sample?
After a couple of bites, you won't even notice it.
Can I have a try before I buy, you know?
We don't normally do that, because I can tell from your face that you're a likable person. There you go.
I am, thank you.
Take that rock.
Oh, ow. That really does hurt.
Yeah, but look,
how do my teeth look?
Better, much better. See, the angle is completely different now.
Grandma, what do you think? How do my teeth look, Grandma?
Oh, happy day. Look lovely today, darling.
Okay. Thank you.
Now try on the other side. Try on the other side. Not with that corner, with the other corner.
With the other corner.
That's
so
right,
I turn it round.
That will take another
It
angle.
Looks like it's actually going to sort of impale my face. Is that all right?
No, maybe you would
go
try
for
the
it,
other
darling.
One. Listen to your grandma.
This is great.
That looks lovely, and that colour of blood is
I look a lot better,
shape.
Don't I?
Yes, wonderful. See?
Oh, so much better, darling.
This department should get more respect than it has previously had.
Thank you so much for noticing that. Have a nice day.
Well done. I actually got an excuse to use the scream on the on the thing.
Oh, what was your excuse that time?
All farmers Inc. does not take any responsibility for any people injured or offended in this.
It's all right. It's all right.
I'm just saying.
Just calm down. Okay, we're coming to our last game now.
Aww.
I know. Okay, that's it. Bye, everyone. I'm kidding. We're going to play the good, the bad, and the ugly. It's an advice game. So we have Josie on good advice. We have Harry on bad advice. And we have Katja on giving ugly advice to the agony letters that we have got coming into the studio. I mean, it's crazy, isn't it? They're really building up. We're going to go to get through a couple. But we're going to start with a letter from Annabelle. Annabelle has discovered recently that on her farm, all of the pitchforks are actually pitch spoons. Josie, what will she do?
Think deeply about what you were using those pitchforks for. Then reconsider the spoon and find inside yourself the true meaning of spoons.
Harry.
Use them. Just spoon everything with the pitch spoons. And then spoon everything with yourself.
Katja?
I think pitch spoons are just as well as pitchforks. I mean, if you sharpen them a bit, you can just use them the same as pitchforks. You can still poke people with them.
Excellent. We have another letter that Dario has just dug out of the pile.
Yes, here it is. I know too many spoon references. What do I do?
Take those references and find somewhere they will be loved. There's a spoon collector society in every good town.
Burn them. Just burn them.
Go and annoy people so much with all your spoon reference. I mean, please them with your spoon references until they get really angry and chase you out of town with their new pitch spoons.
And I've just found this one in the pile. This one's great. This one's from Jonathan. He's 73 years old. He's our oldest viewer or listener. And he's there and he's like, what has happened to the radio show since Alex stopped hosting? That is what he says. Can we have some good advice about what the hell is going on, Josie?
Good advice about the radio show is hard to come by. Perhaps you should ask Alex what he believes has changed since he's left.
I think if you don't like it, you should listen to something else, like the sound of your own breathing.
You should kidnap Alex Southern, plant him in your living room, and have him do improv for you all day long. And probably you'll need some more improvisers, so kidnap those too, and all keep them in the living room, like a big old hoarder.
I think that was our last letter that we're going to be able to do today. Because, yeah. So, well done, guys. That was really good.
Just pressing buttons. Are you going to let me?
What?
Are you going to let me?
Do you want to talk?
Well, it's my show.
No, I'm pretty sure it's my show. I'm the improviser in the room.
Yeah, we're not actually smiling while we're laughing.
No,
it's really sinister. You can't pick it up at home. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you again, guys, for coming in. This has been the improv show, and it's also been the gag show, and it's also been all the other shows and the drama show, all in one combined. Apologies again for the technical difficulties with the gag show. It will be repeated next week, and very soon it shall be uploaded to the URN website, so have a look at it there. We're going to say goodbye now. Yeah, sad times.
Can we play one more last game before we go?
Oh, go on then.
Yeah! Okay.
This is like an encore, but... all right. This is like an encore, but no one actually... stop playing that. No one actually called us on for it. Go on.
So we're all farmers, right, in this room. We've all agreed that we're farmers. We are, yeah. So there are some farmers that farm chickens, some farmers that farm pigs, some that farm cows. But I want to find out what you guys would farm if you were farmers.
So. I would farm online RPG gold.
Well, if I was a farmer, I would farm better advice for myself and all the poor people that send letters here.
I would farm crystal meth.
I would farm tardigrade and take them to space.
I would farm all of them muddy trees that my mum has been complaining about for my entire life.
I would farm farms. You can never have too many farms for farming farms.
I would farm 10-engine tratters.
Tratters, yes.
Tratters.
Those things.
I would farm horse herpes.
Oh, herpes.
I would farm horse herpes pull tractors.
I would farm staring cats.
I like cats.
I would buy some.
I like cats too. Okay, yeah. Sorry about that, everyone. Goodbye. We're going to listen to Bat Out of Hell by Meatloaf. Woo!